Charlie, where are you, Mama? Hey, what's up, everybody? Thank you for checking me out. This is Eko Simpson. We've been talking about real estate. We've been talking about living in Ghana. We've been talking about building in Ghana and then moving to Ghana. Today, I want to bring you something special when it comes to buying a land in Ghana. All right, and specifically Cape Coast. This is where I'm from. I've told you that Cape Coast has the tourist attractions, talking about the Cape Coast Dungeon, Elmina Dungeon, Kakum National Park, and a lot more. Now, I spoke to a friend of mine who has a plot of land that she wants to sell. So I had to come here and make a video. But before that, when you're traveling from Accra to Cape Coast, there are two ways. You either use a branch road that goes into the town, to the Cape Coast town, or you go straight into Elmina, Takrady, and whatever. Now, on the road from Nyamransa or Salt Pond to Cape Coast, if you're going straight, there's a school called Ghana National College. I know most of you know about Kwame Nkrumah. Yes, Kwame Nkrumah set this school up. And I mean, when he was alive, he had to set this school up for the beautiful people of Cape Coast to and gain knowledge. Yes, so this is a senior high school. Just opposite that, there is a school for the deaf and blind. Yeah, so you might want to come here and have an experience with these kids and teach them, you know, one or two things. Hey, so the land that I'm talking to you about is in between the senior high school. In the state, I think you call it college or something, I don't know, but high school. So it's in between the high school and then the school for the deaf and blind. So assuming you are looking at purchasing a land here in Cape Coast, this time I'm not talking about Asebu. This time it is in the middle of Cape Coast. And you are lucky, just in case you want to build a hostel for the senior high school kids. So should you, you know, have a business mindset of setting up a hostel or making some money in Ghana, which I know most of us want to do that, this is a beautiful place for you to consider purchasing. This land consists of three plots. In addition, we have a half plot to it. So you have three plots plus half a plot. Now, a single plot or one plot is measured in 100 by 80. 100 by 80. So you have 100 by 80 three times plus half of 100 by 80. And like I said, this is in between the school for the deaf and the senior high school here. So maybe you might not be thinking of building a resident property. You might looking at building a commercial property here where the student can, you know, come and stay, pay monthly, yearly, or whatever. Put up a comment. Let me know if you're interested in this property, and I'll connect you to the owner of this land, and then you will take it from there. This place is beautiful. I know you saw the Ghana National College, the school for the deaf and blind, and now we are closer to the main wall that separates the school and then the land. Yeah. So I have here with me Joe. So Joe is a representative of the owner of the land. So I just want you to know that Joe is part of the family who is selling the land, and it's legit. Okay. Is it registered?
Yeah, registered.
It is registered.
Yeah.
Okay. So when we come here, or anybody who wants to buy the land, we just have to change the name
of the
owner. Okay, so if you're interested in staying in Cape Coast, where you can easily, you know, move to the beach or the beach side within the next 5 minutes of you driving your own car or picking a taxi, then this is the right place for you to be at. So hey, thank you very much. If you're interested, let me know, put up a comment, and then and I will tell you the price. You know, I don't want to put a price out because somebody might see it in 2 months time and the price might be different. So if you're interested, please send me an email or put up a comment, and then I'll let you